My name is Radu Jupa. I'm doing a 4-year MEng course.
Hi, I'm Matt. I'm a third year about to graduate. I study computer science and I've done a year in industry as well.
Hiya, I'm Elena Elenkova and I come from Bulgaria.
My name is Tomas Simeonov. I'm doing computer science with industrial experience.
My name is Martin Borisanov and I studied here up until last Friday.
And my project is about making a Raspberry Pi controlled robot which you can drive using your smartphone.
And the title of my project is developing multilingual text mining workflows.
I was working on peer-to-peer database over Node.js. That's a system which allows you to store and retrieve information from the web using only browsers and browser-based technology.
My project is analyzing social networks. So I looked at the visualization of social networks and what we can learn about social networks by their visual structure.
It shows a third-year project which was entitled Business Process Decomposition with Web Ontologies.
The best thing about my project was the fact that I got to build something really interesting using a different range of technology. So I've got, I was really keen on learning how to build Android apps because they shape the smartphone industry.
Best achievement was proving that it's actually possible to have a database running in the browsers. That's getting it working, proving that it's something viable, something that could change the future one day.
My supervisor was Dr. Liping Zhao. She was leading a software engineering course in my second year, and that's why I chose her.
My supervisor, David, we met every week to talk about where I was at in the project, talk about ideas and developing them ideas further, what would be a good thing to do, what maybe isn't quite working. He also, if I was having problems, his door was always open.
I got the chance to learn about manufacturing technologies, and some of the pieces you've seen on the robot were designed using drawing software. And then I got the chance to go with FabLab, have a meeting there on how to use the machines, and then the pieces were laser cut.
The big skills I learned from this project are time management, self-management, task management, stuff like that. I learned how important it is to have some sort of routine of managing yourself, managing your work, which helps a lot in the long term.
I had to work with this external tool, which was server-based, and sometimes it just threw some exceptions, some errors, and I didn't know how it worked.
Time management is the most horrible thing. You need to learn how to devise your time to learn new things, to do the work, and still have a pretty good life outside of university.
There was a few challenges in my project because this was actually a joint project with the School of Social Sciences. I had an advisor over there, Martin Everett. However, he went on sabbatical in January, so I sort of lost his expertise after a couple of months. So I sort of had to do a lot of research myself.
Never presume that you have enough time, because things happen. Never presume that you know everything, because you don't.
Do something that you're not that knowledgeable in as well, because I think you'll learn a lot more about yourself and a lot more about that area.
My advice would definitely be to do something you're actually interested in. So if you're passionate about a particular segment in technology or some particular areas of expertise, then go away, read upon it yourself, and that's how you will get to do amazing things.
Go.
There we go.
That's it.